So, this is just a basic OpenStudio model that I'm going to use to demonstrate integration with the OpenStudio SketchUp plugin and the OpenStudio model editor. Model editor is a lot like the IDF editor, if you're familiar with that, but it works with OSM files as well as you can import IDF files. It accesses a lot of the objects within the model that we don't have access to from within the OpenStudio SketchUp plugin. For example, I can see my roof construction is exterior roof, but I can't tell you what materials go into that exterior roof, and I can't tell you the properties of those materials. Similar to that, we have all these schedules that are associated with our project. For example, the occupancy schedule. I don't know what days of the week are in that. I don't know what holidays are a part of that, or what day, time of the day the building is occupied. So what I can do is save this file here, and I'm just going to close that file by making a new file. I'm doing that as a little safety so I don't have the same model open in two applications because you could accidentally overwrite changes you made in one from the other. So this is model editor. I'm going to click the open button to open up my file, which is this model editor demo. And what I'm looking at now is a tree view. These are all top-level objects, so it doesn't look like a tree. But if I scroll down to see my building, you can see that it's a tree view, and I can actually roll things up. I can rename things here and call this my test building. Zone 1. So these are things I could have changed in SketchUp, like for example, making that door a window. But I can also change that here. There might be times I want to. So to get to what I really want to, though, I'm going to switch to the class view, which kind of looks like a table view. It's sorted by object type to start with. And I'm going to look at my construction for the exterior roof. So I can see now I have layers of a 100 millimeter weight, lightweight concrete, an airspace, and acoustical tile. I can use the pull-down menu to change those materials. Or I can actually delete or add new layers to this construction. So what I'm actually going to do is make a new construction here instead. So I'm going to hit the add, and there's a lot of things you can add. And if I scroll up here, surface construction elements, I'm going to add a construction. So I should have a new construction object, which is here, and I'm going to call this my roof construction. And I'm going to add a layer, and the outside layer is going to be, I think we have a heavyweight concrete. I'm going to use that. And then I'm going to have some, let's just put a metal ceiling in. Not something we would normally do, but just to have it there. And let's see if we want anything else. Let's just leave it like it is, like that, with just the two layers. So we'll delete that last one I made. So the other thing I want to do is, actually, you know what? Let's go back to the acoustical tile. So I'm going to go to my acoustical tile, and I'm going to go to copy that, and then I'm going to paste it. So I now have two acoustical tiles, and you'll notice they both have attributes. So I'm going to rename one of these to Alt, and I'm going to make it rough. I might change the thickness, drop the density down lower, so it's a completely different material, and it has a unique name. If you keep the names the same, Energy Plus will not be happy because it won't know which one to apply. So now I'm going to go back to my constructions. Let's go to that exterior roof or my roof construction. So it actually picked the one I copied. I could actually switch back to the F16 acoustical tile or to the custom version that I made. So when you make copies, you just have to kind of manage that and make sure you're working with the right one. So let's go to a schedule now and look at the occupancy schedule. So you can look in Energy Plus to get documentation on this. Some schedules have a fraction where a certain percentage of the building might be occupied. It might be 50% occupied or 75. Other schedules are just straight on or off. or set for a specific temperature. There's a lot of different kinds of schedules, but the point is, I can look here and see on weekdays that 6 until 7, the value is set to 0. That means no one's in the building. Then at 7, 10% of the building is occupied, and then 20%. So it's ramping up, and it's 95% occupied from noon until 1. Maybe that actually happens at 10 o'clock instead of noon. So I can change that here. And maybe from 8 to 10 is actually 50%. So I can go and edit those here. And now when I save my project and quit Model Editor and reload it in here in the SketchUp plugin, all those changes have been applied here. Some of those we won't see, for example. Nothing looks different with my occupancy schedule because I changed it. But when I run a simulation, it's going to use the data from my modified file. I will, however, notice my roof construction will show the exterior roof. I never assigned that to my surface, but it's here now, so I can assign that to my whoops, I don't want interior window. My roof construction. So that's assigned. And also, if I look at my building name, it took that name and it took my zone name. So I'm going to save this again with my construction updated. So that's how you can now pick your actual materials and design them specifically to match what you want for your design. Or if you have an existing building, you can match precisely what's there to get more accurate energy models. So that's really it. To really learn a lot about what you can do in Model Editor, as you see objects, look in the Energy Plus documentation to learn what you can do with them. And that'll give you a lot of control over your simulations. Hopefully you'll find that useful.